Welcome back to the channel guys, and in today's video we are going to feature the new legendary Pokemon that was released last week, and that is Zacian. And this was the Pokemon that I wanted to feature earlier on, but I wasn't really getting very good IVs. I mean, I did have a lot of rare candies to put into a legendary, but I wanted to invest in a good IV rather than any random one. So today I managed to catch a 98 which was 15 14 15, and I was like, yeah, let's just dump some rare candies into it and try to feature this legendary. And I would say that I was pretty skeptical about using that, but when the elo range I am in, I was seeing a lot of Melmetals, Dialgas and Excadrills, and like the legendary dragons are common as well. So I felt like that would make a really good opportunity to feature Zacian. And before we start with the battles, if you're new to the channel and if you like our content, please hit the like and subscribe button. Our channel just got past 600 subscribers, so that's pretty amazing. And yeah, let's keep this growth up, and yeah, let's achieve our target of 1000 subscribers pretty soon. And if you want to join the Battleset Discord server, the link to that is in the description down below. So without further delays, let's start with the battles and see how the battle goes. So we are in a Dialga Mirror matchup, and this is the matchup which I would like to stay and see how the opponent wants to play it out. I mean, the bare minimum we can draw out a shield as well, and if the opponent doesn't shield it, it's going to be really bad. And since I'm farming bunch of extra energy, I'll make sure that, or I don't make sure, but typically how you would want to play the mirror matchup is really dependent on the situation. Sometimes I would like to shield and sometimes not, but looks like the opponent goes for the charge move. They could have simply farmed us down as well. I was nowhere close to an iron head, and now we come in with Zacian and start getting ahead on energy. And since we are even on shields, I think this may be good for us. And Zacian loses the CMP of course, because Kyogre is a very attack weighted Pokemon. So they go for Surf, and now we go for close combat. And without the close combat debuff, I think Zacian took Surf pretty decent. And I was expecting Kyogre to not shield, but apparently they went for it. And close combat did not so much impressive damage, I would say. I was really expecting more damage. And maybe the opponent could have swapped into Lugia after the first close combat. Not really sure why the opponent did not do that. So we shielded the sky attack, so hence I cannot really farm extra. I need to go for this Blizzard immediately, and this will be enough to KO the Lugia. And yeah, the opponent just quits realizing they cannot win this one. So yeah, good game. Moving on to the next one, we are in an Excadrill matchup, so horrible lead. So now I safe swap to Zacian, and looks like the opponent is staying in, so probably they will throw this Drill Run and bail. Otherwise, if they stay in, they probably don't have a good counter to Zacian, or maybe they are freaking out that what's this freaking thing. Excuse me. So they go for this Drill Run, and the Drill Run, I definitely would want to shield if I want to rip off those two close combats. So the first close combat will get shielded, and the opponent does a really great job in catching onto this close combat onto their, I think it's a Mewtwo. Yeah, that was a really great catch. But Mewtwo is also a very squishy Pokemon, so Mewtwo took some decent amount of damage, and we are able to catch a Psystrike onto the Dialga, which is massive. And at this point Dialga is just a energy drainer from my side, because with Excadrill still present, Dialga doesn't really have a play. I was going for a farm down, to be honest, but that did not happen. So I let go of this Ice Strike, and I think now I'll come in with Zacian and farm some extra energy. And since I led with Excadrill, they have a Dialga in the back. So they have a Dialga in the back, and the reason I said Dialga because Excadrill is very weak to Kyogre, and the opponent will shield this Dialga, and we are able to get to another close combat with the debuff. So this will do massive amount of damage, and now I can simply come in with the Kyogre, and the Dialga will just take a lot of waterfall damage. And I didn't really know how much energy Excadrill had, and that's why I went straight away for Surf, because Dialga cannot really get to two charge moves, and looks like the opponent just really quit at this point of time. And yeah, we'll just look at Kyogre swimming in an empty field without the water. But Dialga comes in and we are able to just waterfall it down from barely no health. So yeah, good game. Moving on to the next one, and we are in another Dialga mirror matchup, and this is the reason that I changed my usual line of Mewtwo, Dialga and Zekrom, and the reason for that I was facing a lot of steel leads, and since I was running Shadow Ball, it was a really iffy matchup. So as you can see now, I am going for a very aggressive farm down, and now with opponents barely leave with any energy, barely any health, I throw this Arenet, so they'll shield their Dialga. And now the opponent throws their energy, and now I shield this charge move because now I can potentially get to a Draco when the opponent's Pokemon come in with, and Draco onto any Pokemon will do massive amount of damage. So in comes the Giratina, and I go for this Draco Meteor, which of course gets shielded, and the Giratina will be able to farm us down. So now I come in with Zacian, and definitely they'll go for Shadow Ball because there is no point in baiting at the moment, which does massive amount of damage, and they come in with Togekiss. So the game is still not over yet, in my opinion. I tend to not farm a lot of extra energy, and I want this Kyogre to farm some extra energy, hence I did not charge all the way, and they go for a charge move, and at this point probably my gameplay should have been that I should have put Kyogre to very low, and looks like the opponent has also stopped attacking. I realized a bit late that was the gameplay, and I go for the surf, but actually at this point the game is pretty much wrapped up. Probably my only win con was that I should have come in with I should have let Zacian farm for extra energy, and this is definitely going to be Shadow Ball, which will be able to knock Zacian out. So yeah, that was a play error in that was an error on my part that I could have definitely played that one better. So moving on to the next match, we are in a Mewtwo matchup, and this matchup really depends on whether the Mewtwo will be able to land a Focus Blast if they are running or not. So they are going for Ice Beam, so they are running Psy Strike and Ice Beam, and I go for this Iron Head. So if the Mewtwo wants to keep a lot of energy, they would want to shield this, which typically Mewtwo does, because now they can go for a Psy Strike and put us in a very low health range and can simply farm us down. So I continue to chip at this Mewtwo for some extra health, and as you can see, I did not throw the charge move because I wanted to get a farm of this Mewtwo over the Psy Strike. So for the Dragon Breath. So in comes their Melmetal. So now I make a very aggressive swap to Zacian because I do have a really great counter to Melmetal in the back in the form of this Kyogre. And even if they swap out, they are most likely to have a Dragon type in the back. So they go for a Rock Slide, and I obviously farm up to two close combats. So I go for this close combat. Let's see if the opponent decides to shield or not. The opponent decides to go for a shield, and I pull the trigger on the close combat immediately because I think the another Rock Slide will be able to knock us out. The unfortunate thing is that the Zacian is not able to KO a Melmetal, so this is something which I felt like was quite disappointing, to be honest. But now we can come in with Kyogre, and they come in with Giratina. So I'm not really sure what I was trying to do, maybe trying to find a loose condition by staying in that matchup. So as soon as I realized that, I just swapped immediately and throw this Draco, and the opponent simply quit the game at this point of time. So yeah, good game. Moving on to the next one, let's see, and we are in a Giratina matchup. So this is a positive lead for Dialga, and in comes Dialga, and I was a bit late to the swap, and that's when I made a foolish decision of staying in this matchup. So I would need to shield because I really would want to win the switch here. I cannot really afford to lose the switch because I have something weak to Giratina in the back. And even at this point of time, I swap out now, but at this point, the opponent's Dialga is probably already at an Iron Head, and they force out a CMP die as well. So this is possibly the worst situation that I could have been in. And the opponent does a really smart job of pushing this to a CMP tie, and the opponent now, since we are double debuffed on our defense, we definitely will get farmed down, and with even shields and like Dialga is not at a health where it can survive a shadow ball or even an ominous wind. I would say if the ominous after ominous wind damage, we simply would have gotten what do we call it? We simply could have gotten farm down. So not a very very smart decision from my side, and they will go for another ominous wind. So yeah, and at this point still the game is not over yet. If I had thrown the surf at that point of time, but my thought process was that the Giratina has already thrown the shadow ball. I could have completely farmed them down, but Giratina survives with some energy, some health, and they are able to throw this ominous wind. So maybe they were running an Excadrill in the back, and if that was the case, maybe there was a win condition. So the two losses which I suffered was my own mistakes, and I definitely could have played those matchups better. But yeah, that's it for this video, guys. I hope you really enjoyed watching Zacian in action. I know a lot of YouTubers have already made a video on that, but yeah, it's better late than never. And if you enjoyed this video, don't forget to hit the like and subscribe button. Until next time, peace.